Hello student, hope you all are doing great. This was probably the last slide which we were discussing in the classroom. This is the slide which shows block diagram of the typical ECG machine. The signal which are arrived from the patient goes to the lead selector. This output goes to the amplifier, and ultimately the condition signal goes to the PMMC galvanometer. This PMMC galvanometer has a structure containing a permanent magnet, and in the vicinity of this permanent magnet there is a moving coil assembly. This assembly is attached with one of the stylus or the pointer. In this electrocardiograph machine, this pointer is generally replaced by the hot loop stylus, which moves in the vertical direction over the paper, which is designed to rotate in the horizontal direction as per the speed which is set by this drive motor in the gear assembly. As per the signal which comes from the patient's body, this heated stylus moves over the heat sensitive paper in order to give good frequency response and in order to record the ECG signal which is in the range of hundreds of hertz. The ECG paper generally contains signal like this, where the first signal itself is called the calibrating pulse. This pulse is of 1 millivolt height, which follows by your original ECG signal. If you zoom in, this larger box will find that the vertical height of 5 mm is equivalent to 0.5 millivolt. Now if you look at the horizontal division, if the paper speed is set to 25 mm per second, thus if we calculate 1 mm on the paper, which corresponds to 1 by 25, it means 0.04 second. So ultimately it is equal to 40 millisecond. So as we know that there are 5 divisions, so 5 multiplied by 40, so it will be total 200 millisecond. These readings or these scales are generally used to calculate the height and width of the individual pulses as well as the complex of the ECG signal. So as we have already seen, the horizontal one small box is generally 40 millisecond and the larger box is 200 millisecond, while vertically the one larger box is equivalent to 0.5 millivolt. Generally on the ECG paper, every 3 seconds it means 15 large boxes is generally marked by a vertical line. This particularly helps when we are calculating the heart rate. Here the heart rate is calculated by measuring the R to R interval. One of the most important part of the ECG machine is the ECG preamplifier. Whenever we are using preamplifier, at that time we have to look for certain important characteristic. The first and foremost important characteristic is it should be a bioelectric amplifier having high input impedance. This characteristics enables the preamplifier to deal with very small amplitude signal and in order to ultimately eliminate the loading effect. This preamplifier should have a lead selector switch. It should have a 1 millivolt calibration source as the machine which we are going to use for diagnosing the patient abnormality, that machine should be calibrated. So before taking each and every reading, we used to give or we used to generate 1 millivolt calibration pulse from the machine itself. Preamplifier should have a means of protecting the amplifier from the high voltage discharges such as defibrillator which is used on the patient. Sometime preamplifier will also have an isolation amplifier. So if you look at the isolation amplifier, on the one side we have electrical input, on the other side we have an electrical output. Both the sides, that is input and output, both sides are isolated from each other by means of this optical arrangement. This arrangement is specifically needed for safety. This isolates the patients from high voltages and currents in order to prevent the electrical shock where there is specifically a barrier between the passage of current from the power line to the patient. So it isolates the patient and the power line. This can be done by using a light. So that is by means of a photoemitter and photodetector, or it can be done by a transformer, which has a set of inductors that are used in either step up or step down configuration. So here we will see the both arrangement. On one side we have isolation amplifier by means of the transformer, on the other side we have a optically isolated isolation amplifier. So here there is a mains transformer which is generally used to isolate the power side and the machine side, while there is another isolation transformer which isolates the patient and the machine. On the other hand, in the optical isolator arrangement, we have optical isolator which isolates the patient side and the machine side. These isolations are generally a better way of protecting the machine and the patient as well as the protection of the operator. Nowadays, op-amps which we are using for making the preamplifier or the instrumentation amplifier of the ECG machine has a characteristic of programmability. If you take the example of LM4250 or LM4250C, these are extremely versatile programmable monolithic operational amplifiers. Here the programmability means a single external master bias current setting register programs the input bias current, input offset current, quotient power consumption, slew rate, input noise and the gain bandwidth product. The device is truly a general purpose operational amplifier. Now this is one of the example of ECG circuit. Here you can see that right arm and left arm both are connected to your instrumentation amplifier. The part of this common mode signal is fed back to the right leg through this right leg driver circuit. Whenever we are designing the preamplifier of the ECG machine, always we have to look for certain noise signals. One of the major source of noise is common mode signal. So how to reject this common mode signal? So until now what we have assumed is amplifiers were ideal such that the signal into each terminal would completely cancel each other, which leads to complete rejection of the common mode signal. But the practical op-amps are not ideal. They are incapable of cancelling the common mode signals which appears at the input terminal of the op-amps. So how to deal with common mode signal? If two inputs are hooked together into the differential amplifier driven by a common source with respect to the ground, the common mode voltage should be the same and the ideal output should be zero. However, practically whatever we will see, that is something called offset. So that common mode voltage is composed of two parts. First, in case of the ECG, it contains DC electrode offset potential and it has a 50 Hz AC induced power line interference which is caused by the magnetic and electric field from the power lines. This noise is a current form in signal, common and ground wire. Generally, it is capacitively coupled into the circuit. So by using the instrumentation amplifier which has a high CMRR, so specifically we are using INF128 which gives high CMRR, this helps to reduce the 50 Hz noise as well as the common DC offsets. Now if each signal is carrying similar noise, then the sum of the noise will subtract out with a differential configuration. So instrumentation amplifier generally has two phases. The first stage itself is known as a buffer stage, while the secondary stage is called differential amplifier. Now if the common mode signal appears same as both the terminals of the differential amplifier, then it has the capability to reject this common mode signal and ultimately it helps to cancel one of the major sources of error in ECG preamplifier, that is the common mode signal. Second way is we are using a right leg driver. In this circuit, part of the signal is inverted Here you can see that common modes voltage, whatever we are getting, first it goes to the follower and then after it goes to the inverter. So part of the signal we are taking back through the common through this follower stage, and through the inverter we are again sending that signal back to the patient. So by this particular arrangement we are generally providing a feedback to the patient so that noise level at the patient can be reduced. As if we are using the isolation amplifier, it will also allow to reduce the noise level. In addition to that, we are using shielding of cable. This also helps to reduce the noise further. So if we look at the five strategies which we are using to reduce the noise in ECG machine, the first is common mode rejection. So by using the differential amplifier and the instrumentation amplifier, we can reject the common mode signal. By means of the right leg driver, in which we are sending part of the signal back to the patient itself. By using shielding of the wires, by using the isolation amplifier, and additional circuit which we are using in the ECG machine, which is called the notch filter. This filter also helps to reduce the noise, that is the 50 hertz or 60 hertz noise. So by using these different strategies, we can reduce the noise in our ECG machine. Defibrillator, it is a machine which is used to deliver a high voltage electrical shock to the patient's body while patient is suffering from the heart attack. Whenever physician applies this high voltage to the patient's body, this high voltage can damage to the equipment. Still, the physician needs to look at the ECG of the patient. It means defibrillator is a machine which is used by coordinating or by looking at the patient's ECG. So in this case, we need to provide protection to the ECG machine. So this protection is generally provided by means of three mechanism. First is by means of the glow lamps. They are generally the pair of electrodes which are mounted in a glass envelope in an atmosphere of lower pressure neon gas or a mix of inert gases. Now typically impedance across the electrodes is high, but whenever voltage across the electrodes exceeds the ionization potential of the gas, this impedance suddenly drops, which generally shorted to the ground. So majority of the current safely goes to the ground and avoids your amplifiers. Second mechanism is Zener diode. These diodes are turned on when a minimum voltage is reached. So we are using Zener as a regulator. If a large voltage is applied, that is in case of the defibrillator, the Zener diode will allow current to flow through it and ultimately shunts to the ground. Current goes to the ground, not to the amplifier. Third mechanism is the diode. Diode is a device which conducts the electricity in one direction. Here the diode acts as a resistor. As long as the current level remains below predefined limit. If current rises above the limit, the resistance will change and the current will become clamped. It can also use as a variester. Variester is nothing but the variable resistor which functions like a surge protector that clips the spikes in the voltages. This is one of the effect of voltage transient on the ECG machine. Sometimes a high voltage transient is applied to the patient, that is defibrillator, which causes the magnitude much greater than the biopotential signal which saturates the amplifier. Now, once the voltage transient signal is removed, the ECG signal takes time to recover. So this is the same thing you can see. This is the current transient and this is the time of recovery. ESU filtering. While a surgeon is conducting surgery, he or she will want to see their patient's ECG. ESU is a machine which is generally used for doing cutting and coagulation with high frequency signal, which is in terms of hundreds of either kilohertz or up to several megahertz. This has a magnitude in terms of kilovolts. So this signal can also distort the ECG. This ESU can introduce two type of error. First is it can introduce the DC offset or it can completely obscure your ECG signal. So ESU needs to be of diagnostic quality.